Hey guys, how's it going? This is Documentary Dude, and today I want to talk about the rockumentary film It's So Easy and Other Lies. For any Guns N' Roses fans out there, this film talks about the life and career of Guns N' Roses bass player Duff McKagan. Really, this film, what's interesting is the fact that it's a combination of interviews from himself and as well as people who knew him. And it talks about past experiences and things that he went through. And it does it through like this animation type deal, which normally is, I'm kind of like, eh, whatever. But in this case, they did a really great job. And also, if those two aren't enough, it's also him reading from his autobiography of the same name. So it's like this little acoustic concert he's got going on with his own band that's, you know, not Guns N' Roses. So it's really like one big retrospective of his life told by the people who knew him best. It's got interviews with Slash, Nikki Sixx, Matt Sorum, Duff, obviously, Benny Urquidez, aka The Jet. He's a martial artist who trained Duff when he was trying to sober up. So I thought that was pretty awesome that he kind of developed that mental discipline to train with like one of the greatest martial artists ever. I didn't even know he did martial arts. That's pretty cool. And what's interesting about this is this is based off his autobiography, and normally I'm very weary about documentary films based off of previously published works like books or things like that. So I was very, very concerned, especially the fact that he was reading from the autobiography when he's doing the acoustic concert. So I was like, am I really going to enjoy this? Is this going to be boring? But no, they actually did a really, really fantastic job of painting the picture of his life and career. And it was very intriguing for him to go from where he was to where he is now. As like, you know, a family man, he has at least, I think, one or two daughters, and it's really one of the rock and roll stories where you think that this dude's probably going to be dead before he's 50, to the point where it's like, okay, cool, he's a family man now, that's pretty awesome. You know, some guys really don't have that chance in the rock and roll world, so it's really inspiring to see the guy who cleaned up his act and is where he is today. He's still playing with Guns N' Roses. I think he at one point left the group back in the, I want to say the 90s, I believe. Don't quote me on that. I believe he rejoined the band around the time this documentary was released, so that's awesome. For those of you who are wondering, no, it does not interview Axl Rose, so don't bother asking. Yeah, it's a really great documentary. It's very enticing in the sense that you really get to see a really great picture of his past and where he's been through and how he's gotten to where he is now. And it's really just a way of seeing how, you know, a dude can really go from point A to point B in a very destructive manner and still make it out okay with, you know, love and support from the right people. So yeah, it's a great documentary. It's on Netflix. Again, it's called It's So Easy and Other Lies. If you want to know more about any other documentaries, comment down below, give this video a like, and don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys next week. Peace.